Lord God, we thank you for today and what you have done in bringing Michael and Megan together. We want to begin this time acknowledging you, acknowledging your grace and your mercy by what you've done in the lives of these two young people. And so we pray now that as this ceremony progresses, that you'd be honored and glorified, and that you would bless this new couple.
He is incredibly impressive. I really appreciate the depths of his mind. He's quite empathetic and compassionate. Michael, you've been so good for my spirit in a lot of ways, and this is only the beginning. I'm very excited and looking forward to walking through life with you. I love you. With me, was it out of the blue? 'Cause I swear I never knew it. When did you let your heart run free? Have you been waiting long? Where did you fall in love with me? When did you fall in love? Make your way over here, sit down by this fool.
Megan, I definitely appreciate you taking this journey with me, and you've certainly increased the quality of my life in ways that I never knew anyone could, and that's a very common trope in marriage, but I see now what a lot of love songs are about. And realizing that alongside you is something that I couldn't replace with anything else. Well, I guess it don't matter now that I realize. Maybe I missed it then, but I can surely see it now. Right here before my eyes, you're my beautiful surprise. When did you fall in love with me? Was it out of the blue? 'Cause I swear I never knew it. When did you let your heart run free? Have you been waiting long? Was it the coffee shop, or was it that morning at the bus stop when you almost slipped and I caught you?
Whoa.
They're real. The flowers are real. Oh, I didn't know they nice. Were really real.
Do I get to hug you?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Isn't it pretty?
It's beautiful.
Little train. Not too big.
And I love the flowers.
I know. I thought they were going to be fake, but they turned out to be real, which
they so. Smell great. Mm-hmm. Here's the song, so my lips will be free.
Have you been waiting long? Oh. It looks better than I thought it would. Mm-hmm. I mean, I knew it would, but still.
What about you? What are you?
Real.
The boutonniere.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it is real. Everything's real.
I feel spiffy. I feel old, like the 1800s style. Mm-hmm. I like it. I think this floral pattern looks really good.
The coffee shop, oh, that morning at the bus stop, I never saw the signs, no, no, I'm gonna fall, I'm about to fall in love, and I need to know, when did you fall for me? Smiles and silly conversation, as if this sunny day came just for you. You twist your hair, you smile, and you turn your eyes away. Come on, tell me what's right with you. Now it dawns on me, probably everybody's talking.
And Megan, your companionship has come to mean everything to me. We have survived more together than most people know, and it is in that crucible that I found that my heart is bound to yours. You know me better than anyone ever has, and to be seen, to be really seen, is both freeing and terrifying. Kierkegaard said that the man who cannot reveal himself cannot love, and the man who cannot love is the most unhappy man at all. Through your love, you have created such a sanctuary that I may reveal myself, and in doing so I continually learn what it means to love and to be loved, particularly that at times I'm good at neither one. Yet you love me still. So it is with great honor, exceeding joy, and with much fear and trembling that I pledge myself to you. As your husband, I will be there, and I will choose you continually each day. I will lay down my own interests that you may become who you are meant to be, and will protect your freedom, your dreams, and your spirit when all of life wishes them extinguished. I will seek the Lord's counsel and make his ways our own as our lives merge. Face alongside me the unsettled future, the unquiet past, and the eternal present. Celebrate with me the path to our potential as we say amen to the life ahead.
Michael, this day I take you as my husband. This day I publicly acknowledge the sacredness of this companionship. As my dearest friend, I will commit to learning the mind you possess, the one I so gently fell for. In my love for you, I promise to care for your spirit when wilted, to be a stillness when all is chaotic, encourage you when things are hazy, to challenge you in times where your potential isn't being met. It is for these reasons that I take this sacred vow. As we learn to know the Father and our usefulness to his kingdom, seeking him and discovering our place in his story, I commit myself to your happiness and self-fulfillment as a person. I promise to remain by your side, keeping myself only to you through joy and heartache, contentment and tragedy, as well as peace and adversity, until this life ends or death takes me.
With this ring, I pledge my life and love to you.
I pledge my life and love to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Son, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
With this ring. I pledge my life and love to you.
I pledge my life and love to you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Michael and Megan, since you both have agreed in the sight of the Lord God and the presence of these witnesses to enter into the marriage covenant, and you have both given and received rings as a token of your faith and pledge, I now, by the authority committed unto me as a minister of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, declare that Michael and Megan are husband and wife according to the ordinance of the Lord God and the law of the state. Michael, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Michael Kuhlman.
It's so unusual, it's frightening. You see right through the mess inside me. Tell me I can start again, and I don't need to keep on hiding. I'm fully known and loved by you. You won't let go, no matter what I do. And it's not be a sin.
falling in love with you.
And loved by you. It's so like you to keep pursuing. It's so like me to go astray. But you guard my heart with your truth, the kind of love that's bulletproof, and I surrender to your kindness. Oh, I'm fully known and loved by you. You won't let go, no matter what I do. And it's not one or the other. It's hard truth and ridiculous grace to be known, fully known and loved by you. I'm fully known and loved by you. How real, how wide, how rich, how high is your heart? I cannot find the reasons why you give me so much. How real, how wide, how rich, how high is your heart? Now I cannot find the reasons why you give me so much. I'm fully known, fully known and loved by you. You won't let go, no, you won't let go, no matter what I do. It's not one or the other. It's hard truth and ridiculous grace to be known, fully known and loved by you. And love.